Hello everyone, my name is Talvan and Flippy, welcome back to Wild Alert. So, yeah, this is another post commentary, so, yeah, I screwed up this recording as well, so, yeah, but there's a cutscene coming up, so, yeah, watch.
Rocky boys. No one must hear of this. Do you recognize these names?
They are your generals. But I don't see my name.
Be thankful. I named these men as traitors. They're plotting to kill me. They think I will destroy Mother Russia.
But you?
You have always stood by me. When I regained the land stolen by the Europeans and the Chinese, you were there. You fought nobly to make my dream come true. So now, I'm going to give this honor to you.
Death warrants?
Sign them. Reaffirm your loyalty to me by ridding Russia of her enemies.
Curious. Stalin said nothing about the truck Gradenko abandoned.
Containing elements of Iron Curtain.
Yes. We must get it back. I'm sure you'll find a suitable way to handle Comrade Gradenko.
The truck and its contents were abandoned somewhere in this region. The Allies captured the truck and brought it to this way station. They intend to move it to safe territory and study its contents carefully.
This cannot be allowed to happen. We cannot risk recapturing the truck. It is now a liability. Do not allow the truck or any allied unit to leave the area.
So yeah, we're on game again. I'm saying it again, this is a post commentary, so yeah. Things may be a little bit out of sync, what's happening on screen and what I'm saying, but yeah. But the way this mission works, the way you completed this mission is you need to kill one specific truck and you're done, basically. But the hard part is to actually kill the truck, because if you get close to it, it will just run away off map and then you fail the mission. But oh god, this is gonna be hard, because it is like almost a 15 minute video, so yeah. This is gonna be fun, I guess. Yeah, but the allies will pretty much... the allies are pretty aggressive on this mission. They will regularly attack you, which is why I will put up defenses like as soon as possible, like a few SAM sites and a few tester coils on each entrance. But yeah. But the allies also use like air vehicles or like an air helicopter called the Longbow. And they will just target your Tesla coils always. Like, I'm sure they do. They always target the Tesla coil. But yeah. But oh no, I actually don't know how I can do this for 15 minutes. Like, I have moments that I'm gonna be a little bit silent, and I guess I'm gonna talk about, well, some things are coming on screen, I guess, but yeah. And there's also some gems there at the bottom, which I will harvest soon. Like, what I'm doing now, the reason I build silos down there is to base creep a little bit downwards so I can build a refinery down there, but because there's more ore in that area that I can mine, which increase my income. But the thing is, the ore grows very slowly in this game. Like, I have mentioned it in like in one of my earlier episodes of the Soviet campaign, that's that I speed up the growth a little bit. Like, not too slow, not too fast that the map is gonna get covered with ore, but also not fast enough that that your harvest can keep, so I will run out of ore, but it's just gonna grow a little bit faster back. That's the only thing I changed in this game. Like you can really easily change the like values in this game, like how much damage each units do, how much HP each units and building have, like, and how fast the resource growth. I guess you can also add like how much they are worth. And it's based on the script in this game is based on like a text and a number, pretty much. But usually you have more than enough ore in a position to do the mission. Like, eventually I will just stop building structures and just going go with all tanks. Like, Rattler is basically just tank spamming some later, or whatever you can call it. But the only thing you pretty much doing in late game is just spamming your tanks and then go for it. And that's probably the best strategy you use in this game. It's just spam tanks everywhere. And just rush the enemy. And don't care about losses, because you can usually build them back fairly quickly if you have more war factories. I usually build two. Having two war factories is actually pretty fast to rebuild your units, but some people just build more to get like an insane build speed. But yeah, and as you can see, I built a refinery downwards and I sold off that silo because I don't really need them just yet. Like, I don't think I ever use silos in this mission, at least. In some missions I will, because the thing is, those refineries in this game has a limited amount of resources they can store. I think in this game that's 2,000. I'm not sure. On the silos, I think they will add another 2,000 or maybe 1,500 per silo you build. And if those things are filled, you don't get any more money. So yeah, you either got to keep building units or keep building silos. Hey, and this is the thing I was talking about the longbows trying to shoot down your Tesla coils. But if you build a few anti-air turrets around it, then it's pretty much safe. Which is what I'm going to do now, actually. Like, you can see that I'm already building a SAM site. I'm gonna put it near the entrance where I just got attacked. But yeah, I don't know how I'm gonna do this for like 15 minutes. But I think of something to talk, or I'm just gonna talk what. I was just gonna talk about what's happening on screen or something, but yeah. This is a fun game, but sometimes it has its difficulty spikes from time to time. Like hunting down that truck while it's running at 2, it's not that easy to do. Because your truck is faster than your tanks, and if it's pretty much already out of the base, then you can pretty much just reload your save, because you're gonna fail that. So I'm building a lot of power plants to get Tesla coils, because Tesla coils requires a lot of power. Like, I think an advanced power plant gives 200 power, and a Tesla coil requires 100, if I'm not mistaken, or 150. But yeah. But it's nice that you start up with like a fortified position of your base with a wall, a few structures. But if the walls get damaged, I just don't bother with it. I just leave it there. Because I actually never build walls in these old games because it takes time to build walls. And you can only place one piece at a time in this game. And you can even base creep with walls like you can in Tiberian Dawn. Which you can use as sandbags to build buildings further away from your construction yard. Because the way the base building works in that game, you can only build building directly next to another building. Like you have a building right there and you have to place it like right next to this one. You can place it like up here. But using sandbags you can create some space between each building. But it also requires a little bit of time and a little bit of money. Because I usually don't bother doing that as well. But yeah. I just built the building right next to each other to decrease the time I'm busy with my base and increase the time so I have also more money to put into the units, because in Tiberian Dawn, Tiberian is sometimes very limited on some missions. This game is not that limited because you have a lot of war nearby, your base at least. And there's usually another huge patch somewhere on the other side of the map. And also, they captured my war factory. So, yeah. I did an engineer rush, pretty much. But they only did that once, but engineer rush isn't really not that effective in this game. Like, the way engineer works in this game is like, they damage a building, and once a building has a certain amount of health left, then it will be taken over. Your construction options. Yeah. You can just capture a building if it has full health. But in Tiberian Dawn, at least as a GDI, an engineer rush is really effective. Because you can instantly take over structures and just sell them for money. In this game, not that so much. The only way you want to capture structures is that you want to capture a specific structure. Or you need to capture a specific structure. But if you don't do that, don't bother with engineer rushes in this game. It's not worth the money and the time. Just build tanks instead and just roll with it. Also, I'm finishing up my defenders on the other side, and I think I'm gonna work on the northern entrance now. The south entrance, I don't need to put defense because there's no way for enemies to get there unless they use a transport, which they actually rarely does in this mission. They rarely put the transports near your ore field. I think it only happens to me like twice or once, at least once. I know that, but I think twice. Yes, I want the second Tesla Core there too, so they can survive a little bit more, a little bit better. Due to having more firepower in that area. But yeah. I actually don't know what to say now. Oh god, yeah. Hopefully I don't screw up future videos after this one. Like, I already did one today, that one was of Half-Life 2, and I have another one to do from Half-Life because I screwed up two videos without commentary. So yeah, that's gonna be fun, but those videos from Half-Life are not that long compared to this one. This is like 50 minutes. Like, I'm already on like 30 minutes, almost 40 minutes in. Construction complete. I'm just like busy with my base to make it up and running, and I just sold out that refinery because I don't really need it up there anymore. Because my main income is coming from the bottom ore side, not from the top one. Like you can see my meme, there are two huge patches beneath my base on the little island, I guess. But yeah. And a truck comes towards the kill somewhere up north in an allied base. Yes, sir. And there's just a random transport in there. Just dapping around, I guess, but oh well. Like, I'm now working on my northern defense, like two SAM sites on each side and then two Tesla coils in the entrance. Like, I don't really care how my base locks. I just want to want it up to running as soon as possible. Like my defense, my war factory, my barracks and so, my defenses. I just put buildings where I have space. And luckily in this, they give you a lot of room to build your base. Yes. And sometimes Oetrucks are a little bit derpy, but because, yeah. The way Oetrucks works in this game, they harvest the ore, and once they're done, they will look for a refinery that is open, or not dumping, and they will go to that refinery. And that, it doesn't matter if the one is like in the front of the base, or in the back, if in the back of the base, the harvester will always choose a refinery that is pretty much not in use by another harvester. Which means if another one, if another refinery is not in use in the back of the base, which means that the one harvester that is full will go to that refinery instead of the closest one that is nearby, which is sometimes a little bit annoying and sometimes can destroy your economy if it's not inefficient. So that's why you should only build refineries like in your, inside your base and not only on the other side of the map, because some officers will go through that and may get themselves killed due to enemy resistance. And I think also how the AI works, at least the campaign wise, they pretty much work the same way they did in Tiberian Dawn, I think. I'm not sure. This game has a skirmish mode, and which means they have an AI that can build a base by itself, but for some reason they're using the same AI scripting then that they were using Tiberian Dawn, because Tiberian Dawn doesn't have skirmish mode. And the reason for that is that the AI can't build a base by themselves. They're not programmed to do that. They entirely work on scripting. Pretty much their attack is scripted, the way they place buildings are scripted, they always place the building in the same position if the building is missing. And they also can build a construction yard by themselves without even building an MCV first. Like they can place it like original buildings. Like buildings, which is a little bit cheaty, but I guess but the AI in Tiberian Dawn isn't really that advanced. It's just a really simple AI which relies on scripting. And that's also a reason that you can't have skirmish mode in Tiberian Dawn. But you can see this game is looking very similar to Tiberian Dawn with some improvements. Like skirmish mode. The AI is a little bit more better and a little bit more randomized, but I'm sure they're using the same scripting they were using in Tiberian Dawn. I'm not entirely sure, but mostly sure, I guess. But I'm no game developer. I don't build AIs for games, so yeah. But yeah, sometimes the allies is a little bit aggressive on this map. Like they are pretty much aggressive. They are attacking you from time to time with like 5 tanks, maybe most of the time 3 tanks in my game because I'm playing a medium difficulty. Like as far as I know, difficulty affects mostly how much your units and buildings cost. But I think they also affected the AI a little bit, not too much, but they build slightly more units. But I don't know. I don't really know the difference between hard, medium, and easy. Yeah, only difference I know is how much your buildings cost. Like medium is like the default cost, the hard is like a higher cost, and easy is like a lower cost. That's all I know about the difficulty effects of this game. But I'm not sure if it affects the AI that much. I guess it did, but I don't know. Yes, and I'm repairing my damage thanks to not server's pad. But repairing your tanks is pretty slow in this game. So, and that's why I also sometimes build another one. And yeah, I'm building an army to destroy that base, but the ally also have some naval units. And they have also some cruisers defending the base. The main base, where that convoy truck is located. Luckily they don't give you a time limit on when that convoy truck is going to escape. It will only escape if the convoy if your army is nearby. Or at least one of your units. So I say don't go to the base if you're not prepared. And there's also a minefield which can easily kill your tanks. At least your heavy tanks. But if you have enough of them, you can just rush it and just kill the convoy truck. If you know how to do it. Like, later on I'm gonna do it, but I had a little bit of trouble doing that. Yes, I'm just rushing the construction yard with my tanks, so they are unable to build the structures. And I'm just gonna keep building tanks because I'm gonna lose a lot of tanks soon. Like you can see, one of my mount tanks is severely damaged already. Like there are two like main allied bases. Like one is from a different color. I guess there are like two AIs in this map. But I don't know why this ally base is a different color than the main ally base. I guess what some RTL games do is they just put like two eyes, but they just give them the same color. But for some reason they give another base a different color for some reason. I'm not really sure why, but oh well. Yes, I'm building a sub and I'm just gonna build a subsidy later on to get rid of some ships. Like, I don't have to kill this base, but I want to kill this base to make them a little bit less aggressive. And here, there are now also landing troops in my harvesting field. It's only a few artillery, so a couple of tanks can easily get rid of them. But they're doing that very, very rarely in this mission for some reason. I don't know why. But the artillery are not that strong. Like, they are effective versus buildings, but against buildings, I mean. But they are not. But they have very low armor, very low up, so two tanks can like kill them with ease. And they don't really do that much damage against other vehicles. So yeah, you can see that I'm pulling back my force a little bit, and unfortunately that submarine is stuck, so I have to sell that other one. But oh well. But also, this game is also a little bit unbalanced. Like, the Soviets gets the better units compared to the Allies. Like, the Soviet gets the best units, the best base defense. But I think they have the weakest air. Like, they have the Yak and the MiG. The MiG is pretty strong against buildings, but the MiG is pretty strong against infantry and some light vehicles. But the Soviet lacks pretty much on a good naval, so compared to the Allies. But Allies get like a destroyer, a gunship, a cruiser, which is like the superior Allied ship in this game. So pretty much the Allies rules the sea pretty easily, but the Soviet rules the lands pretty easily due to the heavy tanks and mammoth tanks. Which the mammoth tanks are pretty strong against everything. They can target their targets, they can kill infantry really easily, they can deal with armor really easily. So yeah. If you have the mammoth tanks, you can just spam the living shit out of them and just steamroll your enemy with with these.
Yes, sir. Affirmative.
And they also regenerate the health. Halfway or something. Which makes them so useful. So if you have a lot of damage, you can just pull back a little bit and just let them regenerate some health a little bit and go back. But yeah, I don't know why they decided to give Mammoth the ability to regenerate their own health. Like in future Command & Conquer, like Battle Lord 2, if a unit gets like heroic. Or if they rank up like 3 times, they will regenerate there, but that's applied to every unit in Battle Lord 2. This game, there's no unit promotion. So units can promote if they kill a certain amount of things. Yeah, there's a camel pill box up there. You're barely seeing them actually. And the allies are attacking a little bit, and they're gonna pull back, and they attack again and pull back. I don't know. It's just a little bit weird. But oh well. Like soon, I'm gonna gather an army to get rid of that, to rush that. But you can see that I have a little bit of a trouble doing that. But yeah. There you go, man. I'm about halfway through. Oh my god. It's like 15 more minutes to. Yeah. Or like 25 more minutes. I don't know. And it's the save game. I do that a bunch of times, especially at the end. Like, and yeah, and unfortunately those longbows destroyed my SAM sites. Yes, and I was using my sparring to scout a little bit of the map. And I almost lost his mammoth tank, but luckily those are strong against infantry, so the one with full left just got rid of most of the rocket guys. But rocket guys pretty much sucks in this game. They die really quickly on everything. Even tanks are pretty effective against them, like the normal heavy tank. Like, they're so underpowered, so infantry are not that much useful in this game compared to the original Command & Conquer. And also base defense in Command & Conquer 2, that was also, I think, a little bit more dangerous, at least the gun turret. In this game, it's a little bit weaker, I guess, or the Soviet tanks have just so much HP that the gun seems weaker. Complete. Sorry for those weird artifacts sometimes. I don't know what's causing it. It may be on my hard drive. It may be on a certain hard drive I'm saving on. But if I've saved it on my SSD, I don't have that much left storage on my SSD. I have SSD, but it's only like 250 gigs, and I got like 20 gigs left of it. If I'm gonna record videos on that thing, it's gonna be full in no time, so that's why I'm not gonna save it on that thing anymore. I'm saving it on one of my main hard drives on my computer. But I only see it once in this video, but I guess it's not that bad. And it's like almost 30 minutes in.
Insufficient funds.
preparing. Unit ready.
Yeah, and there's a lot of ore on that side of the mainland.
Building. Unit prepared.
You notice that my economy isn't that good anymore because, like I said earlier, the harvester was screwing up the other harvesters to go into the refinery. But I think I'm gonna put them all now down there to harvest. So yeah, that solves that problem. But I think I'm gonna build one more refinery to increase so the harvesters has a little bit more choice to dump the ore. Yes, and there's a small harvesting outpost up there. I don't know, but I'm not bothering to attack that.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I'm now mostly just waiting on money. Yes, and those airplanes are gonna get destroyed really quickly. I don't know what to say, so I'm a little bit silent for now, I guess. It's actually going better than I expected with this post-commentary thing.
Yes, sir.
But oh well.
On hold. Cancel.
So, yeah, how's your day?
Ready. Select target.
My day was pretty decent, I guess. I don't know.
Construction complete.
Like you can see that those testicles are doing a really good job on defending my position.
Cannot deploy here. Building.
Reporting. Affirmative.
Mission saved.
I think I will now try to go for that ore truck. Ore truck, that convoy truck. At least slowly.
Acknowledge. Ready.
And I almost lost the power plant, but luckily I didn't. That could have given me low power, which means my Tesla coils are gonna shut off. God, I really don't know what to talk about now. I pretty much said everything I wanted to say in this map, but I don't know what to want to talk about now. Yeah, but if you're playing, like, if you're doing post-commentary, you need to feel you talk all the time, but if you're just playing the game, then you're gonna have to, you're not noticing that you sometimes talk, like, as much as you wanted to do, I guess, but in post commentary it's like way harder to talk about things. I don't know. It's just yes, Nera is my attempt to go for a rush, but as you can see, there's a lot of length left of the video, so I'm gonna fill that one. If I succeeded that one, that this video could have been like over right now, I guess, but it didn't. I guess I'm waiting for like more tanks to show up. And also, the pathfinding of units in this game is a little bit, it's pretty bad. Like, they will go like, if you order them to do the alternative, they will at least go like three different routes. Like, the one you want them to take, the one that's kind of good, and the one that's is gonna get through the enemy base, which is not what you want. But oh well. It's an old game though, but yeah. I guess the Bearing Down doesn't really have a perfect pathfinding though, but I think that one was a little bit better compared to this game. And obviously the Bearing Down is also a little bit more balanced game than this game. Reason is why that the GTI gets like the better tanks, but the worst defense of the game. And the North get like the weakest, the North has like the weakest vehicles, but has the best defense. And I think North has also a little bit better infantry. Like, they has the flamethrowers, but the GTI is the grenadiers, which can kill a group of infantry really easily. Yes, you can see there are mines in this area. And you can see that I'm just gonna rush for it, but yeah, that truck is gonna run away and that. And the units go around the dwarf factory, like from the wrong way. And this is the point I know from. Yeah, this is not going well. I'm just gonna fail this one.
Mission loaded.
So, yeah.
Select target.
And also, the music cuts away for some reason if you load the game. I don't know why. It's a weird bug, I guess. I give it. Like the version of what Lot I'm playing is just a CNC net version, which means this game runs pretty perfect on Windows 10. I have not really encountered a crash, like actually never. The game looks fine. And it runs fine. Like, you can hear that I can attempt another rush, but that truck is long gone as I get there. Like that thing is going to run away. Then I got an idea that maybe if I can intercept that, I was able to kill it, but yeah. Unfortunately, that also doesn't work. Like, and I spent some time to prepare myself to get a naval force set up and a transport with tanks, but it doesn't work either. But I just gonna have to rush from the perfect angle. And if I simply block the path, the vehicle will just go on the other side of the map, to the map, and escape from a different way. So I'm pretty much gonna waste time in to build a transport, to put some tanks in there, and then just go on the, and just land on a different shore. Well, I'm getting a little bit tired of doing this. But yeah, like I said in the beginning, the only thing I have to kill is that truck. As I'm clearing up some of these ships, So, allied ships.
Yes, sir. Acknowledge. Affirmative. Acknowledge. Reporting.
Unit ready.
Yeah, acknowledge. Affirmative.
Silence.
Always acknowledge.
Yes, and those tanks are just gonna get allowed to get themselves destroyed by those rocket guys. But oh well.
Building.
Yes, sir.
Silos needed.
Affirmative. Affirmative.
And then just proud of them. Yeah, then behind that bridge is a cruiser, which will attack my units.
Silos needed.
Yes,
unit
sir.
Ready.
Acknowledged.
Repairing.
Yes, sir.
Unit ready.
Affirmative.
Mm-hmm.
Unit repaired.
I don't know what to say, so I guess I'm a little bit sorry now. Sorry about that. But no well.
Silos needed.
This is pretty pointless what I'm doing though, but I didn't know better back then. What I was supposed to do. Like, I was trying to make a small force to intercept the truck, but that didn't work, unfortunately. And yes, and there's a cruiser there.
Yeah,
the cruiser is also screwing it up a little bit. Which means I'm wasting more time to do my thing. This is the first time I actually playing this mission, and I actually have never beaten this game. I actually never played it when it released. Like when this game was released, I was just a few years old. I was born in 1994, and this game was released in 1996. So yeah, I did not play this game when it was released. Like, I think I didn't even have a computer at that age that I was allowed to use. But oh well.
Unit lost.
Awaiting orders. Affirmative.
Spike lane ready.
Comrade, affirmative. Affirmative.
Yeah, that cruiser is gonna be destroyed.
Unit ready.
But the cruiser is a really powerful ship, and it's a ridiculous range. I'm using my spar plane to scout ahead a little bit. So there's another cruiser near the base in this map. Yeah, you can see that I'm preparing my attack again. At least you're attacking a different spot, but the truck is just gonna run on the other side. I don't know how many ways the truck has to. I don't know how many ways there are for the truck to escape, but I guess there are like maybe two or three ways. I don't know. Yes, and this bridge is destroyed. And if a bridge is destroyed in this game, you are unable to repair that bridge. And like in future Command & Conquer games, like in the Red Alerts, you can get an engineer to repair it, so the bridge will instantly get repaired. But in this game, it's not there. If the bridge is destroyed, it's destroyed for good. I'm trying to power bomb it, but that doesn't work because the power bombs sucks in this game. Like they drop the bomb way before they actually get to the target, and also they have anti-air, so this plane is just gonna get shot down. Like you can see that I'm now gonna like attempt to do another rush, but this one doesn't go really well as well. Yes, he has to rush again. Oh, not. Yes. I guess I'm just doing these things around to minimize damage a little bit. Yes, he has to rush again. An attack goes on. Goes to somewhere else and then escapes in another corner or something. Like I was like trying to search for it, but it didn't work. You can see that I will get a mission failed message soon. Yes, like that. I was like, "Fun, goddammit!"
Mission loaded.
And I'm just gonna do the regular rush again, and this one will succeed.
Silos needed. Select target.
I was like looking for where the thing is, and then go for it. Yeah, I just ignore the minefield and go straight for the base. Almost like one quickly attack, and then for some reason the thing pulls back a little bit and just stood there, allowing itself to get killed. So yeah, that's the only thing you were supposed to destroy in this mission. But yeah, this is the end of the video already, so yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys later. Bye bye.